handed leaf blade. See any damage to these. A sign of good steel, good heat temper. Far so good, nothing coming loose, still tight, so sharp. Held up well. Blade's nice and sharp. Now for the leaf blade. And a glancing blow from the trailer, but no edge rolling, no damage, moving on to something. No damage to the blade. Gonna try the leaf blade. As you can see, there's been no edge damage, no rolling, both holding up very well. As moving on to the hardest of the test, I'm going to strike these two new blades against concrete to see how they actually hold up. Here we go. A little scuffing,
of course,
but no real edge damage. No rolling. Would not be hard to rough out. Gonna try to make one. No real damage,
a little scuffing. A little dirt. But they held up well.
I'm known for the hardest of my tests, striking these against granite. Let's see how they actually hold up and if the edges can take it. They actually shouldn't take it. That's abuse to a sword that you shouldn't do. Finally got the edge to take a little damage. But of course hitting granite with a sword will do that. Now for the leap leg. Wore out. Whew. Finally did some damage to that one too. Oh. Never strike a sword against granite. I finally got it to take some damage, but that's more abuse than anybody should ever do to a sword. I test these partially so nobody else has to see where the fail points are. No real fail points for somebody that uses a sword properly. These have both held up well, and I will give my final thoughts in closing. Thank you all for watching. Double review of these two new limited edition swords from the Sword Buyer's Guide. These are made by Scorpion Swords and Knives or traditional archerybows.com. Two very different blades, but both are one-handed. I'll start with the Wakizashi blade. It's fast. It's got just enough weight and power. It's well made, full tang. It held up very well to my destructive tests. I did damage the edge striking concrete and granite, but that can be left out. The leaf blade is heavier with more power, but it recovers well. I was able to damage this blade also finally in the final test, striking concrete and granite, something you should never do with this sword. I did this so you don't have to. They both held up well, nothing came loose, and they both still feel really solid. I do recommend these, no fail points actually. Good tempering. These will be available from what I understand for a limited time. Thank you guys for watching. Till next time. Bye.